USB 3.0 ആണേ.
യെസ് സർ. ഓക്കെ സർ, വി ജസ്റ്റ് സ്റ്റാർട്ട് ദ മീറ്റിംഗ് സർ. Good afternoon, all of you. I'm Shravan Kumar from Delsoft Technologies, New Delhi.
Good afternoon.
So we are going to present a software called NetSim Soft for networking and simulation. For various kind of network, we can simulate here, like Ethernet, wireless, LTE, cognitive radio, wireless sensor network. So we can design any kind of network NetSim software. Through GUI or through programming option. We have two options. One, we can use the GUI, or you can change the protocol in the Visual Studio through programming. So I'll just show you a brief about the software. Why NetSim? Why we use NetSim for these simulations? Because as we know, these communication networks are being too complex, so we can't handle it manually. So we need any tool to design all these things and analyze. So that's why we use these kind of tools to design and analyze various kind of network. So about the NetSim, it is a network designing tool which is used in R&D and defense applications, and it has various wide range of technologies like LAN, WAN, wireless, cellular, cognitive radio, LTE, and sensor networks. It has an open architecture with protocol C source code, and it is being used 300 plus customers across in academic and also in defense applications. So NetSim, it is used in the enterprise and R&D labs in research development area, and in academic it is being used by academician to perform their experiments in the network labs, or they can be used for the PhD thesis M.Tech projects. It is the architecture of NetSim software, how it is being used. Actually, you can run it through CLI, command line interface, or through GUI, graphic user interface. So when you create any design, it will create an XML file, configuration file, that can be open in the XML viewer, or you can change anything in that. And this is the virtual stack, network stack. And when you design a network, it create a matrix. Matrix has some datas, and then event trace, packet trace. So these are the some parameters on which we analyze any network. These are the standards implemented in the NetSim. First is component one. Component one is the base required for all components. Like it has internetworks, Ethernet, ARP, wireless LAN, and shadowing, IPv4, firewalls. All these are included in the internetworks. It's a combination of wired and wireless LAN. Okay. These are the common modules which are used in internetworks. And it has various type of applications. We call it traffic generator also, because you can generate these kind of traffic on any node, like voice, video, FTP, database, HTTP, email. These kind of traffic we can generate on any node. Then we have matrix, packet event trace, packet animator, in which we can see real-time packets moving from one node to another. And these are the international standards on which these protocols are being developed. Like these are on standards, IEEE standards and RFC standards. Then component two. Component two has some legacy networks like Aloha, CSMA, TokenRing, TokenBus, and these are defined on these different IEEE standards. Then we have component three, BGP, Border Gateway Protocol, and component four, Advanced Wireless Network. mobile ad hoc network MANET, in which DSR, AODV, OLSR, ZRP, these four protocols are being used. Then we have WiMAX. In component 5, we have cellular network with GSM and CDMA. In component 6, we have wireless sensor network and personal area network. For running the component 6, you need component 4. Like component 4 is MANET. So component 4 is needed to run wireless sensor network. So and 7th is cognitive radio. Then component 8 is LT, long term evolution. And component 9 is military radio link. So this NetSIM software comes with the two versions. One is academic version, one is standard version. So we have defined in our presentation what are features available in the academic and what are available in the standard version. So we'll see in the presentation what are featured in the academic version and other is for standard versions.
Okay.
So what's new in VTEL? Actually, this NetSIM version currently has 8.3 version. So current version, some features are updated, like in LTE, it has updated. Some OFDM, SCFDMA, MIMO functions have been updated. Then dynamic metrics has been updated. Dynamic metrics is a graphs of some application throughput, link throughput. Hello?
Yes.
Hello?
Hello?
Yeah, could you hear me?
Yes.
Sandeep sir, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear
okay,
you.
Okay, fine. Then UI property view, BGP cellular with stack, new application models. I've told you that it has some traffic generators that can be implemented on the nodes. So some of the application type have been updated, like peer-to-peer, email, and HTTP. Now, NetSIM analyzing network using standard implemented protocols and development protocol, modifying network protocols. Now, modeling and simulation can be done through GUI. In GUI, you can see the this. Screenshot. This you can see some of the nodes. These nodes are created, and when you right click on the property, any node or application properties, you can see these options. It is the screenshot of application. If you click on application tab, you can see application type, custom, peer-to-peer, email, HTTP, video, voice, database, etc. This kind of traffic you can generate, and then source ID, destination ID, and packet size, inter-arrival time. These can be configured on application tab. Then you can generate these kind of traffics. It is very easy scenario. You can just click and drop and click. Now, I just told you that NetSIM comes with academic and standard version. So this analysis is available in academic and standard both. Metrics. This metrics is available in both. When you create a design in network and simulate, you will find this window. Performance metrics. In this, you will have network metrics, application metrics, link metrics, protocol metrics, device metrics. So network metrics has information about the whole network. And the application metrics has information about throughput and output of about the whole network. Then link metrics has the information about different links which are being used in the network. And protocol metrics, it has the information of protocols which are being used in the network. And device metrics, it has the information of devices. Then animator. Animator is also available in both the versions, academic and standard. In this, you can see in the screenshot, there are some packets moving from one node to another. When you design a network and simulate, you will find a packet animation tab. You then just click on that. You will have this packet animation player. And you can see packets moving from one source to another. So it has color variation for control packets, data packets, error packets. Then it has node mobility. You can control the speed, animation speed, play and pause from here, animation speed. And this is simulation timing for which it is being simulated. then some analysis which are available in the standard version only. Traces. So there are some traces available, like a packet trace and event trace. Packet trace has some information about the packets which are moving from one source to another. It has performance validation, statistical analysis, custom code debugging. Then event trace handles records of timestamp, event ID, event type, debug ID, protocol name. These are the information which are available in the packet trace and event trace. I'll show you in one experiment how we can use this in the experiment through software. Then in dynamic metrics, we have some graphs. When you enable the dynamic metrics option, you will have the graphs that you can use during the simulation or after the simulation. That is the option available there. So this is the unique feature which is available in the standard version only. These three features are for standard versions. Then Wireshark. Wireshark, you must be knowing that Wireshark is a real-time packet capturing tool. So when you run Wireshark. So when you enable Wireshark. Hello. Hello.
Yes.
Yeah. Could you hear me?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Okay. Fine. So this is the Wireshark real-time packet capturing tool. So when you enable Wireshark on any node, it will automatically started when you start the simulation. Then it will capture the real-time packets for you. So it has some also feature for graphs, some conversation graph, IO graphs that is available in the Wireshark. So these are some unique features which are available in the standard versions. Now development platform. So this is the unique option which is available in standard version. In this, writing custom code facility. So the protocol which is being used in the NetSim, that can be edited in the Visual Studio environment. So this screenshot, you must be seeing that there are some programming portion. In this, we have inserted a hello world, print of hello world command. So when we run any protocol having this command in the simulation, then command line CLI interface will prompt with the hello world printed. So that is interrupted when you run the program. So we just show you how to implement this program in the simulation so that you see that we can change in the protocol. So after enter, you will run the simulation. To access protocol source code, we have installation directory, C program files, NetSim standard. In SRC folder, we have some source codes that can be run from there. Okay. So these are the APIs for protocol developers, which NetSim provides. Like packet.h, lang.h, list.h, all these available. Now it has a command line interface in XML based. So you can run it through command line interface, or when you run the GUI, it will create a XML file that can be easily understood and better presentation. We have 300 plus customers from the defense and education field. So NetSim is used by some of the accumulation for their research work and their lab purpose. Now we'll start the software presentation, in which I'll simulate a small network to show you how a software works. This is NetSim software environment. Hello. Hello, could you hear me, sir?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Sandeep, sir, can you hear me? Okay, okay, sir. So we just start the software presentation.
Okay.
Okay. So this is software environment. When you click on the link icon, this will open the software environment. So you will have some options here: simulation, then programming, utilities, help. We have some of the user manual given here for NetSim user manual for whole the software. Then NetSim source code help for programming. Then NetSim experimental manual. We have included some of the experiment in the experiment manual so that faculties or students can design some experiment and see how the software works for different technologies like GSM, CDMA, and LTE. All these. So for starting any experiment, you have to go to simulation, new, and then internetworks. Internetworks has a combination of wired and wireless network. Then legacy network is there. I've shown you in the presentation that these are the available. Advanced wireless network, Manhattan IMAX. Then cellular network has GSM, CDMA, and wireless sensor network, PAN Zigbee network, and cognitive radio and LTE network. So we'll just have a small network and network. This is the environment of the software. You just have to drag and drop the nodes and design the network. Here you can see there's some of the nodes: wired node, wireless node, UE, WiMAX subscriber, mobile station, CRCP. These are for different technologies. So which node is not available here? That is available in the different technology when you use it. Like UE is for LTE, so that is available in the LTE network. WiMAX is for WiMAX. WiMAX is for cellular networking. CRCP is for cognitive radio. Then there are some switches, routers. Link has two types, wired and wireless. Wired and wireless. And access point is there for connecting. Access point is there for connecting wireless node. And these are the nodes which are available in the different network, like wireless sensor network. Hello, Naveen sir?
Yes.
Is there any query, sir?
Not right now.
Okay, okay. Fine, sir. So we just drag and drop some of the components here. Then some routers. Then we connect the access point to have some wireless devices. We just combine a wired and wireless network. Connect it through wired link. Then we'll have wireless link to connect access point and wireless. Now, when you want to have the properties of any node, you just right click on properties. You'll have the information about this node, wireless node, and XY is the position of that node. Then Wireshark is available. So Wireshark, I've shown you, when you online this, it will be enabled. When you run the simulation, Wireshark will run. Then in transport layer, there's transport layer protocol, TCP, UDP. Then network layer, IPv4. And interface of Ethernet, it has IP addresses, subnet mask, default gateway, and in data link layer. So some of the parameters are enabled to change, and some of the parameters are default. So there is one good thing in this software, that there are some tabs available here, and all tabs have the I button. When you click on I button, that will show you the information about that tab. Like if anyone doesn't know the what this tab will work, so that can be information shown from the I tab. Like ARP retry interval, the time interval between two consists, and I mean the definition of that tab. Just accept. Likewise, we can click on the node, right click properties, we'll have the information of properties, the link type, link medium, link mode, and maximum uplink speed, downlink speed. So these are the information we can change from here. You can change it to no error and accept. Then there are properties of switches. There are device specific properties. Like in switches, you have switching mode, speed, Ethernet standards, all these things are there. Then in router, you have router specific properties like scheduling type, buffer size, ARP interval time, retry limit. Then for access point, it has access point specific properties. So you can click in for default values. Then for wireless properties, it has link type, link medium, link mode. Channel characteristic is there. Connect and network path loss. Now we want to generate some traffic from one node to another, so we just have to drop down this application tab, right click properties. Now we'll have in application, you will have application type. I've told you in the presentation that it has some of the application type like CBR, constant bitrate, custom, email, HTTP. These kind of application traffic you can generate from any node. So if you click on a custom, then you have to decide which is source ID and one. Like we send the traffic from 1 to 6. 1 to 6, then packet size, inter-arrival time, you can make it to constant or exponential. You can change the values also. Accept. Now there is a line that a custom type of packet is being sent from wireless wired node 1 to wireless node 6. And now there are some features I've shown you in the presentation, that packet trace, event trace, dynamic matrix are available. So when you want to create packet trace, you have to click on packet trace and file name, and these are the attributes which are available in the packet trace. All these attributes you can select all, and TCP, wireless LAN, you have selected all the attributes, so click on OK. Then event trace, for event trace you have to write the name, and these are the attributes which are available. Then dynamic matrix, these are the option, plot graph after simulation or during simulation. So during simulation, it will slow down the simulation. So we'll select plot graph after simulation. So it will create graphs for throughput for all the links, link 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay.
Then we just start the simulation. In simulation, we'll have the option of simulation timing. We just select it for 50 seconds. And in packet animation, there is option record animation, play and record animation, don't play, record animation. So if you don't want to see the simulation and see the metrics only, so you can select don't play, record animation. The simulation will be faster. So now we have to see the animation. We select record animation. Click OK. And it will start the simulation. We'll have prompt this CLI window. Now we have selected for the Wireshark, so Wireshark software will be started automatically from this. I can see there are some real-time packet capturing from Wireshark. Simulation is still running, so till 100% it will capture all the packets. So when you scroll down this, you can see packets moving from, yeah, this packet capturing from the network. So simulation is over. After simulation, we'll have this window. Performance metrics. So I've told you in the presentation that it will create some of the metrics like network metrics, link metrics, queue metrics, TCP metrics. These are the information about network. Link metric, it has that information about all the link payload transmitted, bytes transmitted, overhead transmitted. Then in whole network metrics, it will show you the simulation timing, packet transmitted, packet error, all the information. Then we just see the packet animation, how are packets moving. When you play the simulation, you'll see the packets moving from source 1 to destination 6. You see a green, you just see the green packet, custom type packet is moving from 1 to 6. Again it will acknowledge and send the packet again. You can change the speed from slower to faster, it will move faster.
Okay.
So you can stop it and go for other analysis. We have selected the packet trace, event trace. So when you open packet trace, you will have the file in CSV format, Excel format. This is a packet trace. It has the information about all the packets.
Yes.
You can scroll down, you will have the information. So this is a packet trace. Likewise, you can open event trace. So it has the information about all the events happening in the network, event type, event time, device ID, all this information is given in the event trace. One more feature we have selected, it was dynamic metrics. So it will show you the graphs of the link throughput, link 1, link 2, link 3, then application throughput. So these are the features for dynamic metrics. Then we have one more option, we have to just save it. And, go to NetSim Analytics. When you click on this, you will have this analytics window. In this, there are different type of network. Whatever network you want to see, just click on Enter Networks and browse the metrics file from here. Like if you click on Enter Networks, select some of the Enter Networks. Metrics file we need only. So you can see we can compare some other experiment in the analytics on these parameters like simulation timing, packets transmitted, packet error, packet collided, bytes transmitted, payload transmitted, overhead transmitted. So this is a comparison of different networks. By changing the parameter, we can see the difference between these networks. So this is a comparison purpose. Likewise, we can compare different kind of network like LTE, legacy, BGP, BGP network, advanced wireless network, MANET, WiMAX, cellular, sensor, all these networks can compare. In Wireshark also, we've seen some packets have been captured. So Wireshark has also some features like in statistics, when you go to the conversation, it can also show you some parameters like in TCP, when you click on this, you'll have the graph for some parameters. Click on graph type, time sequence, throughput graph, then RTT, round trip time, window scaling. So these are some features in the Wireshark. Then you can have some IO graphs. You can select from here. TCP, IP, ICMP. You can add some more. Just have to change some settings from here. You can see the comparison of three types of graphs. So these are the features in the Wireshark. So this one is a feature where I've shown you the complete flow of doing any simulation of any network through GUI. Now, if you want to change any change anything in the protocol, you have to go to the Visual Studio. So I'll just show you. So in NetSim standard, it has been installed. It has the installation directory in program files, NetSim standard, SRC. First in bin folder, there are some DLL files. Actually, this software runs with linking with all the DLL files for protocols. So when you want to change anything, you have to go to the simulation and click on this NetSim icon. After clicking, you will have the Visual Studio window, this one. So all the 22 protocols which are available in the software, so that will be open in the Visual Studio. So here you will seeing that it has DSR protocol, DSR.c file opening here. And I have added a command here, fprintf hello world. So after entering this hello world statement, I've built it. After building, you will have a DLL file of DSR. In DLL folder, there is libdsr.dll file, which is being created after debugging the dsr.c file and entering that hello world print statement. So when we copy this libdsr file from here and enter it in the actual bin folder of NetSim and replace this libdsr file with the original file. So to secure our original DLL file, we just rename it to libdsr default. And now we can copy our build DSR file here. So now when we call that DSR protocol, that will run through our DLL. So just have an example. Let's take this wireless sensor network. So it's a wireless sensor network. There's some sensors, then sync node and agent. When we run this simulation, it will call the DSR protocol, but it will run through our DLL. So it will show you a hello world statement written in the CLI when you run this. See, hello world is there. Hello world. So it is working through our DLL. So that's how we can enter the DLL file there and link it with NetSim. So So when we enter this, it will continue the simulation. It is just to show you how we can change the protocol. The sensors and sync node agent have some speeds given in default. So according to the speed and the distance given, it moves according to the timing. So after some time, the sensors and sync node, all the nodes will change the position. So we just stop it. So this is one example of wireless sensor network. Likewise, you can design any kind of network, cognitive radio, LTE, cellular network. And there is one more option I've shown you, programming. Here are some sample programmings given. Again, just click on cryptography, substitution. You will have two options in mode, sample mode and user mode. In sample mode, there is some sample programming given there. And in user mode, when you want to run through user mode, when you click on this, you'll have a prompt open window to select the executable file, exe file. So that you have to create in Visual Studio and link it with the NetSim. You have to create that exe file. Or you can run it through sample programming, which is given in the source code. So when you click on this interface source code, it will run in the Visual Studio. It will show you all the programs. So just we run this through sample programming. Click run. It will Hello, sir, could you hear me, sir?
Yes.
Sandeep, sir?
Yes, 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 I can hear you.
Naveen, sir, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. So you can see that plain text has been converted into the cipher text. Now when you click on description and run, it will then decrypt that word. So this portion has a combination of programming and GUI option, both. It has some details about this experiment, like cryptography. You have all the details about concept, algorithm, pseudocodes, flowcharts, all this information given. Now, when you click on interface source code, you will have program in the Visual Studio. So likewise, you can design any of the network in simulation and do the programming. So this is a NetSim tool to design any network through GUI and programming both. If you have any query, you can ask me or you can mail me anything. Hello.
Hello. Could you please send me the presentation PPT to my email ID?
Yeah, I'll send you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Anything more, sir?
Okay, Shravan Naveen this side.
Yeah, no.
Hello.
Yeah, Naveen, sir.
Yes, I just wanted to confirm, is there any kind of childhood available which we can go for and we can just have a look of that, how it works for, or it's a kind of a tool which is available which we can download?
So currently, sir, demo version is not available. We can give you a presentation and discuss with you for any technical queries.
I believe I already got the presentation, but I also need to have that kind of PPT, which I believe Mr. Sandeep was asking. I also will be required that. And
yeah, I'll send you those PPT, and we have some videos available on the TEDCOS channel. And you
okay,
and go to the YouTube and TEDCOS channel. You will have all the videos having different event experiments conducted there. So you can go through those videos that have all the informations. These videos are there. All these videos are available.
I got that, but I just want to know, is there any option we can go for security devices to get have a look of that in NetSim?
Security?
For some security devices.
Security devices are not available, sir. But we can do some encryption, decryption programming there. Virtually we can do anything, sir. In Manet also you have some intrusion detection system for security purpose. It has you can design Manet by adding a malicious node in this. So it has some options of security.
So currently I'm doing my project on intrusion detection system. So would I see, use the software to show them the simulation regarding the nodes that are being intruded?
Yeah, you can use it. Use NetSim for this Manet intrusion detection. It has video, sir. When you go into the YouTube, you can see this video.
You told us there's the academic version for the NetSim, right?
Yeah, but academic version doesn't have the custom code facility, sir. I've told you. It has GUI option. You can design anything, analyze anything, but you can't change anything in the protocol, in the custom code. Yeah. In GUI, you can do anything, but also some packet trace, event trace, dynamic metrics, these are not available.
Is packet generator available?
Yeah, this generation is available. Packet generation is available, and animation is available. This GUI thing is there, but you can't change anything in the custom code.
So
if you are going for the research purpose, you should go with the standard version. For practical purposes, you can use just to analyze, you can use academic version. So I'll send you the presentation and you can go through that, or there are some videos available on the YouTube, you can go through. Or if you need,
so if there is any doubt, could you please provide me your mail ID so that I can contact you for further details?
Yeah, sir, I've sent you a mail. You can.
Yes, okay. So yeah. Your mail ID is there, right?
Yeah.
I'll mail you if you have any queries.
There, I have my contact number is also there. You can contact me anytime.
Okay, thank you.
So we can have some more discussion if you want.
Yes. I think I'll be having some guy. Let me go through the PPTs once again. If I'm having any queries, I will. Email you regarding my
notes. Yes, sir. You can mail me.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, sir. Okay, Naveen, sir.
Okay, Shravan, I just want to confirm, is there any licenses available for it, and for how many users can go for it to have?
Yes, sir. Licenses are available for academic institution. It has a minimum for 5 users available.
And how much does it cost?
For 5 user with all the modules I've shown in the presentation, I'll just show you. In standard version, you have to purchase these components. If you go for these component one, phase two, so price is according to the component. So if you want to have the all the components, the pricing are different. If you want to choose some components, the pricing will be different. I'll send you a quotation if you need, sir. For
yes, please.
Yeah, I'll send you the quotation.
You have my mail ID. You have my mail ID in, the, yes, in which sir. You can attach quotation, and you also can attach PPT, because I have to go with the senior manager department as well to have discussion with this for financial use.
Sir, you are from Aero PC Technologies.
Right.
Okay. So, but sir, these licenses are for academic institutions. So
I understand.
Yeah, yeah. So if you want to have these academic licenses, you have to purchase it through any institution or institute.
I understand. My manager needs to have the quotation.
Okay, okay. Okay, sir. Then we'll send you the quote according to the academic licenses.
Thank you, Shravan.
Okay, fine,
thank
sir.
You,
thank you.
I'm waiting for your mail.
Yeah, yeah. If you have any queries, you can call me.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Sure. Bye-bye.
It's run by. It was nice to have a conversation with you.
Okay,
I hope you will mail me the PPT.
Yeah, fine, sir. Fine, I'll mail you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Bye.
Okay.
Hello, Shravan.
Yeah.
And it was fine. And when is the next webinar? Any supposed dates? Planned it.
It will be around 3rd November, 2nd or 3rd November.
Okay.
So we'll mail you the detail.
Okay. Yeah. And will it be like new customers, or will you continue with whoever has attended already? Or
yeah, we'll send you the details to the customer and you.
Okay.
Yeah.
And do you have a custom code, Sleet, Syncall and all, intrusion detection?
Intrusion detection, I have to download those malloc, that file, malicious file, na?
Okay.
Yeah, that I have to download.
If you want us to, if you want some help from our side, we are there
at
any point.
I'll need one presentation from you on that intrusion detection system.
Okay.
Yeah.
You can talk with Pranav and let us know so that we'll fix a date and.
Okay. We'll do that.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you. Okay.
Thank you.
Hello, Niranjan sir. Can you hear me?
Hello.
Yeah, Niranjan sir, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, sir, you have seen the presentation?
Yes.
Okay. So if you have any query, sir, you can tell me or you can mail me.
Okay.
Okay, sir. We'll have the discussion again. So should I leave, sir, or you want some more information from me?
Leave now.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Welcome.